Welcome back, Nick and Lex here. Thank you so much for joining me on another video. And this is going to be something different. This is going to be the Have You Heard section, or just the, you know, music with Nick. I've been in the talks with Alexia about maybe doing videos by myself, but just the longer ones, the ones she can't really sit through. And but the song I've chosen today, and it's kind of funny because it's, since I put in the descriptions, Have You Heard, and this song is called Have You Heard. So it's kind of fun wordplay here. So this, of course, is dedicated to our good friend and supporter Mauricio de la Rosa. Thank you, Mao, so much. You know, you blessed us with your requests, and we learned so much about Pat Metheny. This is the only song that I really knew by heart, and I actually learned this one. I learned how to play this one for a band that I was in Puerto Vallarta. And so that was my introduction to Pat Metheny, and I had this album, and I really love this one. So Have You Heard I've always had a soft spot for that one. So I'm going to do Have You Heard, and this is for you, Mauricio, since you've not requested that one. That this one is on me, and if you don't mind, I'm going to like actually sing along, because I used to sing along live when I played this. I don't know if it's Richard Bona or if it's the great what's his name? Oh Lord, he's so important. Let me just look up the name, because the guy from the singer from Argentina who's so good. Because otherwise I'm gonna get killed. Okay, let's see all the different vocalists. Pedro Aznar. There we go. Pedro Aznar is not going to stop until seeing that. So, yeah. So, I'm going to do a little bit of Pedro Aznar. And today I saw Mauricio, and it really warmed my heart when he said, You know, you're at a good place when you see a Pat Metheny video, and on the next video is like a death metal video. Because, I mean, yeah, music is music, you know, and I think the more music you explore, the better. So, and you shouldn't limit yourself. And this whole thing that I posted about this guy, I was just so shocked, you know, that he was just like, oh, there's too much metal on this channel, so goodbye. And I was like, well, first of all, yes, there is a lot of metal on this channel. But I mean, it has opened up, you know, the door for other people to join and subscribe and enjoy and be happy, you know. And I know metal is not for everyone. And I'm not even that. I mean, I'm a metal fan, but it's not everything. I used to play jazz for years. I didn't listen to metal for years. So now I'm coming back, it's so much fun, you know? And yes, sometimes it's loud and it's obnoxious, but sometimes it's great. You know, there's a lot of good stuff in metal music, you know, a lot of education and a lot of school that comes from classical music and from jazz and from blues, and it just got louder. That's what that is, you know? So it's really nice to explore all these bands. Like Narvik has sent me all these bands that I've never had an idea that existed, and to dive into Rainbow and understand why there's this guy that I so much appreciate, but who was there before, who influenced him to play the way he does, and you know, and so this goes on. And like, for example, if I look back into the history of Pat Metheny, he was very inspired by George Benson. I love George Benson. I use a lot of George Benson. I use a lot of George Benson's licks myself when I play. You know, these octaves, you know, it's a really beautiful way to play. So, well, Okay, so now, well, thank you so much, Mauricio, you know, for being such a huge part of the channel. Everybody, there's all these key figures, you know. We have Michelle, we have Rudy, we have Mauricio, we have Narvik, we have Tony. There's so many, we have Greybeard. There's so many people that are really important, you know. I don't name all of you, you're hundreds and hundreds that I, more personal, you know, Eric. And we have Nick's and Randy's and, you know, and BMAC and all these people. And forgive me if I don't remember you, but I mean, we have Toby. But you know who you are, you know, and we love you. And so without further ado, let's get started. We're going to do Have You Heard by Pat Metheny. I love this song. So excuse me if I sing along. I'm not going to be trying not to be too loud. But yeah, it's a beautiful tune. And Alexia's heard this as well. So it's not like I'm, you know, spoiling it for her. She knows this one. So that's why I'm doing it. Okay, here we go. Beautiful song from the album Letter from Home, 1989, Pat Metheny Group. Since there's so many different Pat Metheny outings, I like to mention that. Okay, here we go. Enjoy. Thank you. Okay, so I have to stop because if not, they're going to block it. I know they're going to block it. I don't want this to get blocked, but what a solo, what an expression, what a tone. The tone of Pat Metheny is just, I don't know. It's just so sweet and it's just so joyful. It's so, there's so much enjoyment. It's just, it gives me like goosebumps. And there's so many guitar sounds that I love that are so instantly recognizable, just, but Pat Metheny is one of them. Alan Holdsworth is immediately. Al Di Meola as well. Very staccato, very, there's this fuzz of distortion. Like something that Pat Metheny doesn't, he uses more like, almost like it, like I'm looking at my pedal, it's more like a compressed reverb with some little bit of overdrive, like very, 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 very small. I mean, you can't really say it's overdriven because it sounds so clean, but there is something that he uses and that beautiful delay. It's just it's so sweet and so like, you know, like you want to eat it. But yeah, so I just love Pat Metheny and I do miss him on the channel. And that's why I decided when I saw Mauricio's comment, I was like, I have to do some Pat Metheny. I've done so much metal. Because I love jazz, you know, and I would love to do more jazz, but we still haven't that audience yet. Like when I did, when we did Stolen Moments, like it didn't get a lot of views. When I did Alan Holdsworth, it didn't get a lot of views. Pat Metheny has its fan base, but it's very small. And that's why I try, like Alexia and I, we try to like do a little bit of everything to please everyone. And yes, the metal thing, for example, has just worked really well because there is some guys that are really passionate. And they're like, hey, Nick, you know, do this request, do this. So it's had really worked and also just like it has really, like Alexia sees me and she's like, you're really like super happy. And I'm like, yes, I'm enjoying this so much. And, you know, I love the comments and people are subscribing and they love the channel. And it's not like some kind of ego trip. It's just broadening the horizon. You know, we do all the 70s stuff, 80s stuff, some metal. Why not? And I wish we could do more jazz and have more jazz people watch the channel because everything connects, you know, all this music, all these musical style have something in common. So it's not like I'm doing like a reggaeton all of a sudden, you know, because that's where the money is. That's where the people we would have hundreds and hundreds of thousands of subscribers if we would do that. But I'm not going to go there because that is something that I don't consider music. I just don't support it, you know. But I mean, I wish we would have a classical sections where I could do hundreds of videos and react to Beethoven and Mozart. But who's going to watch it? You know, that's the problem. So with the metal, at least there's enough people that love that style, you know. And so that's why I'm doing it right now that I have more time. And Alexia, she likes the metal. I played her some Rhapsody yesterday and she was like, wow, like what is this? And but it's like nobody clicks on it because they're 19 minutes long and they're too long. People are just scared and they're just going to... They think, oh my God, that's why I put on the description, please watch this one, you know, do yourself a favor, learn how to appreciate. It's not too loud. You can listen to metal at a very low volume. It's beautiful. They sing in Italian. They have flutes. They have Celtic music, dance music you can dance to and study. And it's wonderful. You know, I'm really, really sad that people don't give, especially that band Rhapsody that I've posted 5 videos of. They don't get the love they deserve, and it's really first class, right? So back to Metheny. So this, I hope my singing is not too off, but I'm trying my best, and I do need to pause because otherwise I'm going to get blocked by the record company. I know Pat would never block the music, but the record companies, they don't care, you know? Okay, so let's continue. Let's go back a little bit. Let's see if I can sing along a little bit more, and I'm sorry. if I'm ruining the song for, but I'm just, you know, it's, this is a video I've already done before. It's not a reaction video. It's just more like a, I want to share, you know, so here we go. Beautiful song. Look at that pedal. Lionel Mazes on that pedal. All right, here we get. That was fun. I hope I didn't massacre the song. It's a beautiful song, a beautiful solo that I honestly, I mean, I could play pretty well back in the day, but I never learned it like note for note. I would need to, like, the sheet music, and it would take me, it's a very long solo. It's like minutes and minutes. I think it's like 5 minutes. It's 5 minutes. The whole song is like 6 minutes, but the solo is like, I think like 2.5 minutes or a little bit longer. And I just knew like the important parts of the solo. So I would just improvise always. Over that solo, and but I would love to just learn the original one day. I might do that one day. But it's not like Kid Charlemagne, that's like just a minute. It's not even a minute, it's like 45 seconds. But this is a long, very difficult, very fast solo, very a lot of diminished runs, a lot of modes and scales that are. I mean, just the speed of the whole thing is very complicated. So yeah, it takes a lot of skill. So yeah, maybe I should try, but it would take me weeks and weeks of just learning that. So that's why I would always improvise it. I would just like try and not play out too much outside, because I mean, of course, the whole thing about this is to play outside as much as possible, but without sounding outside. You're just like right around the corner of the chord, you know. So within the realm of jazz. So if you don't know what you're doing, then you sound like, yeah, he doesn't know what he's doing. So what do you think? Have you heard this before? What do you think about Pat Metheny, all those new subscribers, you know, that listen to metal? All our old subscribers that listen to 70s and 80s rock and yacht music and our Steely Dan fans. And we have so much people that love so much different styles of music. So we should all unite and, you know, and enjoy everything a little bit, you know, because it's, I am sure, like an old metalhead like me, look, I'm the biggest Steely Dan fan. See, because it's so good. And it's like this other guy, I think, I don't know, I don't remember right now who it was, but I see him constantly. And it's like, they ask me, what do you listen to? I listen to good music. So it can be death metal, it can be punk, it can be surfer rock, it can be rap, you know, it can be classical music. As long as it's good, I'll listen to it, you know. I mean, heck, if there's good reggaeton, show me. Show me and I'll react to it. But it has to be good. And that's, you know, that's something I just haven't heard. Good reggaeton. I just think it's very, very poor. And but reggae, I mean, come on, reggae. I'm like, I grew up on Bob Marley, you know. Reggae is, it shouldn't even be put in the same sentence just because it starts with the same three. It's not reggaeton is not based on reggae. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know what you think. Like I said, I hope I didn't butcher the song. I had a lot of fun though. Singing. I think I've never done that before. I think a little bit with Alan Holdsworth. People were like, okay, I can't hear the song because you're singing over it. But thank you so much for being part of this community. We love you all. We love all your comments. People are going to come and go, you know, that's normal. But I welcome you to stay. And if you want to go, I wish you all the best. And I hope you find that perfect channel. So without further ado, that would be all for today. I'm going to do some more requests and I wish you a great day. Take care.